be with me, so basic. Well, you the op and your bros hating. All of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing. I knock them down to their cold cases. Marathon run, I'ma slow pace it. They did not want me to go places. Foiled plans like the gold place. And if we pulling up with the whole squad, are you ready? Done told y'all that you better be running. I'm in my goal yard. When I walk in, I know y'all.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Portland Snowhawks and the Houston Oilers. This one taken just inside the 10. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
First down is locked. That's going to be caught by Richardson. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. Lock now on first down. That's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down. So the same tandem connecting on back-to-back throws to start the game.
And maybe throwing the scouting report off just a little bit. That's not exactly what they think is going to be their number one receiver, but he's producing already early in this game.
From midfield, here's Locke. He's going to wind up and air it out. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. What a play that turns out to be. 36 yards.
Get over here.
Into the red zone. It's Locke. That's complete. Right away. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. A 14-yard touchdown. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. And it's good to make it 7-0.
Makes the score Oilers 7, Snowhawks nothing.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line.
They'll take over first down and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. A run there on first down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it second and 5.
Tackle made.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. Kenny Clark busting through to get him for a loss of 6.
Third down. Third and 11.
Throwing is Allen on third. Able to find Isabella. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. The result, a first down as a quick slant gets him 14, counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11. at the 29-yard line.
On second and 11 now. Allen, now they set up the screen. That's complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 11 yards there, first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
Allen going to throw. On the move to his left. Now he'll let it go deep down the left sideline. Andy Isabella was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, that was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Now they try the right side here. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. They'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two, because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Allen now. To throw on third down. Oh, good down in the air, and now it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. And while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
The snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Locke will try again on second down.
Skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Now he's flushed out left. And that will be incomplete.
Sideline and incomplete. It's fourth down.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 15. And he will be out of bounds on what will wind quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Oilers 7, Snowhawks nothing.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And you know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Second and 10.
To throw again on second down. Wow. Quick throw here. That's complete. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Pass hard in downfield. And they're going to get this beyond the 30 before he's taken down.
First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
On first and 10, here's Locke. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that one. He read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
On second down now, it's Richardson. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
It's a gain of six.
On third down, Richardson. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
A two-yard gain. It's fourth down.
They'll go for it. It's Locke. Steps away to his left. He may try and run for this. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. Now it's Richardson. And he'll get him down after a pickup of eight. Second and two. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two.
Pickup brings up second and two.
Now to the air. Locke. Now the ball comes loose. And the defense will get their hands on it. Costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think they should take the ball to bed with you. And just
and that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown! A big play there. 72 yards. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
Well, this is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels, and that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield and really created a big play.
Well, you said jumbled. They were the definition of jumbled defensively. One play and into the end zone. Offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 48. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line.
At their own 48.
All right, work with me, partner. This is a classic understatement. Their execution has been very poor. Last three drives, two interceptions and a fumble. Winning football? We're not seeing it right now.
So after the INT, it's Allen. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
And a Portland first down.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. 34 yards there and a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
We remind you that coming up at the half, we'll hand things off to Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have scores from earlier today, plus a look ahead as well, so you won't want to miss that alert. And it's intercepted at the goal line! Dante Jackson picks it, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
First and 10 at the 41-yard line.
On first down, Locke. No escape for Locke, and he'll go down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Another try after the first down sack. Block. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Mecole Hardman, the intended target. And that'll make it third down. From the gun, it's Locke. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow him to convert a third and 18. Locke now on first down. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And this is taken in at the five. And all the way down to the five. A big play there just before halftime. 44 yards. Locke looks to throw it again. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked up. And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. Get this across the 20 before going out of bounds.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but it doesn't matter what you call a position, it's who you put there, and there we saw a completion.
Now a second timeout called for by the defense as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. They go play action here on first down. Forced out to his left. He'll have a first down past the 40. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. And now they'll throw with Allen. And he finds a man with a crossing route. He's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Down, and they're going to throw it at it, eluding the pressure right. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
And incomplete.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And his kick is absolutely perfect. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
And they will rank him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
At their own 28-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we have reached halftime here in the Thursday night opener, as we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. See if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And a short kick taken at about the 16.
They'll take over. First down and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. To the air, Allen. And this is incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Allen off the play fake. Rolling to his left. Josh Allen, very athletic at 6'5", showing the versatility, picking up the first on the scramble.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
Handoff looking right. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
So a 1st and 10 now in Houston territory at the 45-yard line. Now a handoff here to his running back. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front They won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Adams' throw is complete. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first?
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air. Nice chunk of yardage there. And then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down.
And it brings up third down.
This time, Allen will throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
After the turnover, here's Locke. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Locke again here on second and ten. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Gain of 13, it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Locke working out of the gun. Completes it to Hardman. Touchdown, Houston. Mecole Hardman, 48 yards. And his guys are going to retake the lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route. Take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field, and that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with
it. Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
At their own 23-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
One one quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Here's Allen to throw it. Now they go screen. It's complete. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. And the screen only good for three that time, and it'll bring up a fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. He can run for it, and he will. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. So they've gone for it twice now on fourth down of this game, and both times unsuccessful.
I wish we could hear the headsets now between the head coach and the offensive coordinator. Now that they're 0-2, if they get into a third situation, head coach might say, hey, you got anything for this one? Might get radio silence back.
Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And this would have been intercepted if he could have gotten the feet in. Instead, it's incomplete. Boy, that really could have turned this one upside down. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. To throw again. Block. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
Makes it third and four.
From the gun on third down, Locke. He's got his man, that's Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. His fifth catch tonight, and it's good for a first down.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Again, they'll throw with Locke. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
It's second down and 10.
Throwing again. Lock. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
27-yard line.
Again, it's Lock. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Mecole Hardman. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. And it's up and good.
Makes the score, Oilers 21.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And a fair catch signal for and taken successfully.
They'll take over first down and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a two-score deficit. And that is incomplete. Andy Isabella was the intended target, but it's going to be second down.
Second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Now they try the right side here. He's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
That ball complete to Isabella. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
First down, fourth down.
They'll buy some time right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I'm not even sure I know who this guy is out there playing right now. This is very unlike him, one of the most accurate guys in the league. Totally off his game right now.
I don't know. I was going to ask you what you put on, but defensively, they've been pretty solid.
Well, sometimes, you know, those defenders, they get into the receivers pretty well, and if they chip away at their timing, it's going to affect what you're doing throwing the ball as well.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. Well, look at the the clock. You're down two scores. Have to go for this, don't you?
And they thought that as soon as they took over possession. It didn't matter where they were on the field. They were always going to be in four down territory. Backed up, in good situation. It didn't matter. So they've been preparing for that on their play sheet the entire time.
So they're going for it, and here's Allen. Over the middle, it's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down being chased out left. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Allen again here on second and 10. Dancing to his left. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's caught. Touchdown.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Fielded right around the 8. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
At their own 20-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
Exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use it all their time. Feel like they have this one in hand.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They fake the handoff. Now Locke. He sets to fire deep.
One of the head coaches, you know, if you're in this spot, why would you throw the ball? And he talked about trust in his quarterback and trust in his offense.
But still.
And then at the end, he kind of went, yeah, not really a good reason.
Out to his left. He's going to take off with it. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down. He'll look to throw. Steps away. Throw left side complete. That's Glover. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Allen to throw. They'll roll him out right. He's going to let it fly. And that's caught inside the 35. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now Allen. Buying time to his left. And he will not throw it away. He goes out of bounds, well shy of the line of scrimmage, so that's a sack. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. Shotgun now. Here's an inside give. So they get half of what they needed. It'll be 3rd and 6 upcoming. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. They got to get to the 23 here on third. To throw. Allen on the move to his left. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds a defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback. I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. To throw is Allen. And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages. So Allen breaks the huddle, and his guys will go for 2 here.
So for those of little faith, guess what? It got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown this late in the contest. I wonder if that was a play they were holding or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
Well, I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before starting that last drive, and they did. You're right. They got it done. Looks like they're going to be the winners. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking 2 plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one. Whether you're able to get into field goal range, try another deep pass, another Hail Mary, but you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. He's back to throw. The right side going to be caught by Hardman. Said and done. And now they get the timeout call. So they got one of the big plays that they needed. Can they do it again? Don't change that dial. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. With 2 seconds left in regulation, this to force overtime. And this doesn't get there. It's no good. They had to go for it, but their final effort here is going to come up short. Well, my friend, for the players, it's good for them to get that first game under their belts. For you and I, that first Thursday night game, also good for us to get that under our belts, wasn't it?
It was no longer preseason. We were into the regular season, the first game of the year. And, you know, all eyes were watching this one. Everyone was excited that football was back.
And it's just special. You could just feel it. It's so good to have the pigskin back out there. It'll be crisp fall weather before we know it.
You got that right. But I love the buildup to it, right? All day long anticipating it. And then we got here and we saw a game, the first game of the year. Let's keep going.
So for our visitors, they start.
don't know, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, but I'm a heavyweight. Baby, I know what's coming, I can barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, but I'm here to stay. Stop calling me low, bro, I got mileage on me. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it. More action and no talk, I went quiet on it. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it.
Hey. Face it, well, you the op and your bros hating. One of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing. I knock it out to their coke cases. Marathon races, coke cases. They did not want me to go places. Foil plans like the gold place. And if we pulling up with the whole squad, I get ready to told y'all that you better be running. I'm in my goal yard when I'm walking out.
Stop it, quiet, if it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish. Masterpiece, bought it, bought it.
Hey, I don't know no, but I'm on this every day.